everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel Physios Healing Touch. Today I will tell you how to detect tightness in some lower limb muscle through test. To detect tightness in muscle is really important if you want to diagnose some orthopedic conditions such as piriformis syndrome. In this syndrome, what actually happens is some part of sciatic nerve or whole sciatic nerve passes through the piriformis muscle in some people. And when this piriformis muscle becomes tight, it compresses the sciatic nerve. And when the sciatic nerve gets compressed, it produces pain in the leg and all those symptoms of sciatica. So that's why with the help of these tests, we can find the cause of sciatica. And the other orthopedic condition is lower cross syndrome, in which there is a classical pattern of weakness and tightness of muscles. So with the help of these tests, we can detect such conditions. Without any further delay, let's start this. The first test is Thomas test. It is used to detect contracture or tightness in hip flexor muscles. It is very common contracture seen in hip. One thing to note here is when these muscles are tight, it also causes excessive lordosis in patients. It is because hip flexor muscles also attaches to the pelvis. So when hip flexor muscles will be tight, it will cause anterior pelvic tilting. And because of that, there will be excessive lordosis in the patients who has tightness in hip flexor.
For Thomas test, one of the lower limb of patient will be flexed to flatten out the lumbar spine and to stabilize the pelvis. If there is tightness or contracture in iliopsoas, then the other leg will rise off from the table and this will be considered as positive Thomas test. But if there is no contracture in hip flexors, the hip will remain flat on the examining table and it will be considered as negative Thomas test.
The next test is piriformis test. As the name itself suggests, it is used to detect tightness of piriformis muscle and it is especially important to diagnose piriformis syndrome. As I already told you in starting, piriformis syndrome means in 15% of the population, some part of sciatic nerve or whole sciatic nerve passes through the piriformis muscle, and if patient will have tightness in piriformis muscle, it can compress sciatic nerve and it will cause leg pain.
So for piriformis test, patient will be in sideline position and the uppermost leg will be tested leg. The hip of the tested leg will be 60 degree flexed and the knee will be also flexed. One hand of the examiner will be on hip to stabilize the hip and the other hand will be on knee and he will apply a downward pressure. If there will be tightness in piriformis, patient will complain pain, and if the sciatic nerve is also pinching, then patient will complain pain in the buttocks and along the sciatic nerve distribution. But if there is no tightness, patient will not complain any pain.
Now, there are two tests to detect contracture or tightness in rectus femoris muscle. So first is Elias test and second is rectus femoris contracture test.
For Elias test, patient will be prone lying and examiner will passively flex the patient's knee. In case of no tightness, there will be no flexion at the hip. But in case there is contracture or tightness in rectus femoris, when examiner will passively flex the patient's knee, the patient's hip will also flex like the way it is happening in this video. Now the second test is rectus femoris contracture test. For this, patient will be over edge of the table and his one knee will be flexed to stabilize the pelvis. The other knee will remain at 90 degree flexed in case of no tightness in rectus femoris muscle. But in case of contracture, the knee will extend like this and it will be considered as positive rectus femoris contracture test.
Now the next test is 90-90 degrees straight leg raising test. And it is used to detect tightness or contracture of hamstring muscles.
For 90-90 straight leg raising test, patient's hip and knee both will be at 90 degree flexed. Then ask the patient to extend the knee. In case of normal flexibility, this angle will within 20 degrees of full extension, and this angle is known as popliteal angle. But in case of tight hamstring, it will be greater than 20 degrees, as you can see in this video. And you have to check hamstrings of both the sides.
Now the next test is Uber's test, and it is used to detect tightness in iliotibial band or tensor fascia lata.
For Uber's test, patient will be in sideline position and his lower leg will be flexed for stability and his upper leg will be testing leg. So first, therapist will abduct the upper leg and then extend it and then slowly adduct the leg so that it touches the plinth. In case of normal flexibility, it will touch the bed. But in case of tightness in TFL, when the therapist will abduct, extend and then slowly adduct the leg, the patient's leg will not fall on the table like this. So it will reveal tightness in TFL.
So this was it, guys, and I hope you really liked my video. And if you want more such informative videos, then please subscribe to my YouTube channel, Physios Healing Touch.